It's another Q&A edition of Optimal Health Daily, episode 1526, and I'm Dr. Neil, your host of the show. Welcome back to another special Friday edition of Optimal Health Daily, where I answer your questions. On the other days, I read health and fitness blogs to you, kind of like an ongoing audiobook, and always with my commentary at the end. Now, if you're wondering about my credentials and about my background and why I call myself Dr. Neil, definitely check out the first Q&A episode from earlier this month. But for now, I'm going to spare you from all of that background information and get right to today's question and start optimizing your life.
Hi, Dr. Neil. My name's Cher Eisenberg, and I'm calling from Tucson, Arizona. I'm a very active and fit 53-year-old woman. But why I'm calling you is I'm quite stymied by what to eat the day after extreme workouts. So we're talking very fast, 5+ hour mountain hiking. And what can I eat to recover from such an activity? The next day, I feel worn out and like I just can't get my food right that next day. Also, I'm vegan. I'm a listener of your podcast, and so enjoy it and look forward to your answer. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.
Hi, Cher from Tucson, Arizona. Thank you so much for taking the time to send me your question, and thank you so much for your kind words. I'm so glad you find this show helpful. And in fact, this is a perfect question based on not only last week's Q&A, but Wednesday's show from Eric Lea, where we discussed eating to recover. That was episode 1524, by the way. Now, I'm going to start with general sports nutrition recommendations based on the American College of Sports Medicine guidelines. Then we'll talk about adapting these recommendations to a vegan lifestyle. Now, I realize, Cher, that you were asking about recovery, but proper nutrition and hydration, pre-workout and post-workout, are important. So let's start with the pre-workout strategy. According to the American College of Sports Medicine, before the workout, the goal is to consume both carbohydrate and protein. Especially if you're performing long-duration activities, consuming both are really important. Now, when it comes to fat intake, I'm basically going to skip over this because there aren't specific recommendations for fat intake other than the usual stuff we hear. You know, things like choose healthy fats like omega-3s and monounsaturated fats and so on. So when it comes to carbohydrates, how much do you actually need to consume before the activity? It's recommended that 1 to 4 hours prior to starting the long duration activity, aim for 1 to 4 grams of carbohydrate per kilogram of body weight. Okay, so let's say someone weighs 125 pounds. To convert this body weight from pounds to kilograms, which is what we need in order to do this math, we divide weight in pounds by 2.2. So, let's see, punching this into my imaginary calculator. Okay, we see that 125 pounds is equivalent to 56.8 kilograms, or let's just round up and say 57 kilograms. Since the recommendation is to aim for 1 to 4 grams of carbohydrate per kilogram of body weight, this means that at the very least, the goal is to consume about 57 grams of carbohydrate 1 to 4 hours before your activity. Now, based on this calculation, if we were to multiply this out and, again, base 125-pound person on our recommendations, we would say 57 kilograms, which is 125 pounds, times up to 4 grams of carbohydrate. That would mean the person could eat 1 to 4 hours before the activity up to 228 grams of carbohydrate. So you really just need to find what works best for you. You could have as few as 57 grams of carbohydrate 1 to 4 hours before the activity, or up to 228 grams of carbohydrate. Oh, and for perspective, 57 grams of carbohydrate would be about 2 slices of bread. Now, these sources of carbohydrate, whatever you choose, should be low in fat and low in fiber. This will help prevent any gastrointestinal issues when performing the activity. Now, protein. When it comes to protein pre-exercise, there is no specific recommendation. The recommendation is basically go ahead and consume some lean protein along with carbohydrate 1 to 4 hours before the activity, but that's basically it. Now, as far as hydration is concerned, The goal is about 2 hours before the activity, drink 16 to 20 ounces of fluid. What about during the activity? Okay. Again, share in your case, since the duration of your activity lasts for hours and hours at a time, ensuring that you properly fuel your body over this period of time is important. So when it comes to replenishing carbohydrates, the recommendation is to consume 30 to 60 grams of carbohydrate per hour of activity. This will help keep your energy levels up. Now, when it comes to type of carbohydrate, the same rule applies as before. Aim for low fat and low fiber carbohydrates. When it comes to protein, there aren't really any established protein recommendations during exercise. That's because the research studies that have been performed were inconclusive. Instead, it's more important to eat protein after the workout to help heal the muscles. But I'll get to that in a moment. When it comes to hydration, the goal is to drink 3 to 7 ounces of fluid every 15 to 20 minutes if possible. And lastly, and possibly most importantly, what to do after the activity is over. It seems that post-workout or post-activity nutrition may be the most important for recovery, along with, of course, stretching. When it comes to carbohydrate refueling, try to get in another 1 gram of carbohydrate per kilogram of body weight. So again, if a person weighs 125 pounds, that would equate to about 57 grams of carbohydrate. Aim to consume these carbs within the first 30 minutes of completing the activity. Then consume another 57 grams of carbs in another hour. Repeat this for the next 2 hours, so 4 hours total. Now, what's great about consuming carbs after the activity is that they help absorb any protein you eat at the same time. So speaking of protein, after the activity, aim for about 20 grams of protein within 20 to 30 minutes of completing the activity. There is a specific amino acid called leucine that might be even more beneficial after the activity. Some studies have found that proteins that are full of the amino acid leucine may improve muscle repair and muscle growth. And again, consuming carbohydrate along with your protein source improves the body's absorption of protein. The American College of Sports Medicine also says that most people can meet these carbohydrate and protein needs without supplementation, even those that follow a vegan lifestyle. I'll get to that in a second though. Water. Now, as I mentioned in my commentary on Wednesday's episode, the best way to know how much to rehydrate is to weigh yourself before and after the activity. The goal is to drink about 20 ounces of fluids for each pound of body weight lost during the activity. What's interesting is cold drinks, so those between the temperatures of 40 to 50 degrees Fahrenheit or 4 to 10 degrees centigrade, are absorbed more quickly than warm or room temperature drinks. And in fact, cold water is usually recommended in hot weather to help lower body temperature. Okay, so what can we recommend for those following a vegan lifestyle? Luckily, there are many vegan carbohydrate options. So that's something I probably don't need to go into a whole lot of detail about. Now, when it comes to protein, luckily, there are vegan sources of that oh-so-important amino acid, leucine. In fact, beans, lentils, nuts, and seeds are all good sources of leucine. Now, for those that aren't following a vegan diet, all animal-based products contain leucine. Now, what about those meatless vegan alternatives like I talked about in last week's Q&A? Those, again, I would use sparingly just because we don't have a whole lot of research to know what happens over the long term when we consume those foods. So I would try and consume as close to the real whole food as possible. Now, finally, what about taking a multivitamin in order to help with recovery? The American College of Sports Medicine says that taking a multivitamin and mineral supplement is not needed just so long as your diet isn't too restrictive and you're consuming enough calories each day. But in your case, Cher, a vegan diet may not contain enough vitamin B12, omega-3 fats, calcium, and iron. So you may want to discuss these with your doctor or a registered dietitian nutritionist. Thank you again so much for the question, Cher. Now, if you want to submit a question, you can just email it to health@oldpodcast.com, or you can call in your question just like Cher did by dialing 61-I-LOVE-OHD, or you can submit your audio question at oldpodcast.com/ask. All right, thank you so much for listening. Thank you for sending me your questions. And I'll see you back here over the Halloween holiday weekend, where your optimal life awaits.